Hey, what's up, guys, and welcome back to Anime King. And today I'm going to be giving you part 6 of What If Naruto Was From the Two Greatest Clans. Remember to get this one to 200 likes as usual. Share this to all of your friends on your social media platform. And also, stay in tune for What If Naruto Was Neglected by F1. I'm going to be posting a new episode of that, guys, so stay in tune for that and enjoy. And also, I posted a new episode of What If Naruto Was a God Amongst Men over on Anime King 2. So go ahead and check it out and enjoy. And I also posted a new episode of What If Naruto Was a Deceitful God. So go ahead and check out that as well, guys. And remember, if you're new and this is the first time hearing my voice and you enjoy the videos on both Anime King and Anime King 2, go ahead and click that red subscribe button and become a part of the Anime King family. And thank you for all of your help and support. Remember to comment down below and tell me if you're new. I'll be replying and talking back to all of you. So yeah, without further ado, guys, let's begin this new episode. Start the intro. So the last time we left off, Naruto found himself on the Dragon Island as a crimson dragon brought him towards a leader, as the leader had a prophecy that one day a boy will come here, and it really happened. As Naruto was brought to the dragon called Ragnarok, the leader of this island. As this dragon was rather old, as he was also joking a bit, as he told Naruto he was going to eat him, but he was kidding. As he was here when the Sage of Six Paths was. Dragons are mystical creatures in this era, as the Sage had put on a seal on the island that they were on, to seal it away from the rest of the world, so no one can come here except for the one that will guide this world from darkness, or plunge it into darkness. And the dragon believed that Naruto has those two options, but he will help him along his path. As the dragon told Naruto that he possessed the Mokuton inside of him, why is he not using it? As Naruto was confused as hell, as the dragon started telling him a few things, the dragon also told him about the Sage of Six Paths, but he didn't go into specific details. The dragon then sent the Crimson Dragon to go and get his son Keiji. As the dragon told Naruto to not go down that path, there will be two of them, and one of them will try to convince him, but he should not go down that path, as Naruto was confused as hell. This dragon was talking in a lot of riddles. Keiji then came as he didn't want to go with Naruto, but the dragon told him that he will see his full potential, and he needed this trip, this journey, because once he's done with it, he will be the rightful heir of the Dragon Clan. As Keiji was surprised to know that his father was stepping down. Even though his father might seem old, he has a lot of good years in him, as his father told him that his time is going to come sooner than expected, as his father is always with those riddles. As Naruto and Keiji left, the dragons also brand Naruto the summoning tattoo, so he can access for their help in dangerous battles to come, because he will need them. As Naruto came back home, as Keiji flying him towards the tower, as his mother and his grandmother was there and grabbed him and hugged him tight, as they asked him what the hell is going on, as Jiraiya and Kakashi was focused on the little dragon, as they couldn't believe what they were seeing. As Naruto explained everything that happened to him, as Minato was shot, the Sage of Six Paths, he thought that was only a legend, and Naruto would be the savior of this world, as a lot of things were going through his mind right now, and to hear that Naruto possessed Mokuton, as he really wanted to see what this dragon is talking about, as he wanted more details. Keiji's stomach started to rumble as he told him that he wanted food, as Keiji was rather arrogant, thinking that he is a bit above them because they're humans and he's a mystical dragon. So yeah, guys, that was basically the last part we left off. You guys can switch across the place to take off yourself, so let's start this new episode. Minato and Kushina were standing on a tree branch, as Minato had a smile on his face while Kushina had an angry look on her face. As she scowled at Minato, he noticed that as he turned at her with a sheepish smile. "He's gonna be alright," said Minato. "This is unfair," said Kushina. "There are too much on him." "Well, he was the one who said that he wanted to be pushed and challenged. It doesn't matter if anything happened to my baby," she said, as her hair started to flow in the air wildly, as a red crimson aura was leaking from her, as she gave Minato a death glare. As Minato gulped, He'll be just fine, he said. You better make sure of that, she said to him. As Minato simply turned his head back to where something was blurring through the forest. As the thing landed in the center, as he was in the clearing looking around, it was Naruto. As some years has passed, he was now 12 years old. He has also grown a bit and his hair was now down in his back, and he's gotten a bit muscular thanks to the intense training regime he has been going through. Ever since Naruto found out that he was supposed to be the savior of this world, the prophecy, he has been taking his training dead serious. He has changed over the past years. As Kushina noticed that, well, not a change for the worse, but something for the better. He started to study, he wanted to know more about Fuinjutsu, and he has done so much. And that made Kushina smile to know what he accomplished over the years. As he really did possess Mokuton. After a training regime with Yamato, as Kushina found out that Yamato was an experiment by Orochimaru, and he survived the test that gave him Mokuton. As Tsunade was pissed off to hear that, as she couldn't believe Orochimaru did these things, as Sarutobi kept it a secret, but Minato feel that he was right to tell them about it, since Yamato was starting to train Naruto. And Naruto has also been getting training from Sarutobi. Seeing that Naruto is a rare boy indeed, possessing all of the nature affinity, that was a day when Jiraiya tests Naruto, as he burst into Minato's office to show Minato that Naruto has all nature, as that wasn't heard of since Sarutobi Sensei. Sarutobi was glad to hear that, as he was teaching Naruto a few jutsus in his arsenal, and Naruto has been getting training from Yamato in wood style, and not to mention that Tsunade has been training him along with her superhuman strength, and his mother has been training him along to use his chain, and his father has been helping him with his Sharingan, as Naruto has a three-totem Sharingan up to this point, and he has also been working with Samantha and Sasuke, as the both of them Sharingan has reached the two-totem. They haven't unlocked the last one yet, but Naruto was training more intensely now, as he wanted to be the savior and save everyone on this world. It doesn't matter who or where they are, he will stop this upcoming darkness that Ragnarok told him about. As Naruto was in the clearing, his three totem Sharingan activated. As he was looking around, suddenly a blast of electricity teared towards him. He jumped out of the way as it destroyed the tree behind him. As Naruto then spin around, as Sasuke appeared a brutal kick towards his head, but Naruto blocked it as he grabbed Sasuke's feet and thrust Sasuke away. Samantha came from the sky with a drop kick. He grabbed her ankle as he flipped her over his shoulder, throwing her towards Sasuke. Keiji appeared in front of Naruto, his mouth already wide open, as he released a stream of intense flame. Naruto quickly substituted with a log as the log was roasted. The moment Naruto landed, he was assaulted from behind by Yamato, as Yamato thrust a kick in towards Naruto's back. Naruto managed to leap over it, as Yamato then grabbed Naruto by the back of the shirt and pulled him down to the ground. But Naruto twisted his body in mid-air as he turned his hand, a Rasengan formed in his palm in seconds as he thrust his arm outwards. Yamato turned his hand into a wood vine as he smashed it straight into the Rasengan, as the both of them were blown apart. As Naruto landed gracefully. It seems your reaction time has gotten a lot better, said Yamato. That's thanks to all of you, Naruto said. But I'm not done yet. Come at me, he said. Time skip. 30 minutes later, the trio was sitting on the ground as they were cooling off. As Keiji was over there sleeping, as Yamato gone back to his duties, as this was just a testing scenario, as Naruto wanted to see how strong he has gotten. They have tested each other, and all of them have improved over the years, but Naruto is by far the best. Naruto looked over at Sasuke and Samantha, as things have changed over the past years. The tension that they all had, after they started training back together and everything, all of that just simply vanished, and they slowly regained their bond and their relationship. As long as no one brings up Itachi, the mood would always be fine. Minato and Kushina were there as well, as they were looking down at the trio. As Kushina walked over to Naruto, are you hurt anywhere, she asks. As she started to pat him down to find any injuries, Mom, I'm fine, Naruto said. It looks that way, she said. Don't do something stupid like that again. Huh, Naruto said. You can't face four opponents by yourself. That is why you have friends and comrades. Even though you're strong, Naruto, you're not invincible at your age. Well, he's a lot stronger than I was when I was at his age, said Minato. Kushina glared at him. Don't put any thoughts in his head. As Minato stepped back as Naruto chuckled, the Hokage and everything, but you're still afraid of mom. What did you just say? She asked, looking at Naruto. Naruto gulped as he shut his mouth instantly. As I thought, she said with a sweet smile. So, how do you think we do that? Naruto asked. Well, I must say all three of you have improved. And I have no doubt that you will pass the exam with flying colors. Well, if it was up to me, I wouldn't have even given you guys the exam. You guys have already showed genuine level material. Really? Said Samantha. Of course, Samantha, all of you have improved. I already know that, said Sasuke. But we need to get much stronger. And besides, me and Samantha don't even have the three totem Sharingan yet, but Naruto does. That's because I am just much more awesome, Naruto said, as Sasuke grunted at that. Don't worry, Sasuke, you will activate it soon, Naruto said. As Naruto then yawned, as he looked over at Keiji who was sleeping. He then looked at his mother. You know when he wakes up he's gonna be hungry, right? Kushina looked over at Keiji, as she just gave him a warm smile. As she was happy for the dragon, she was happy for all of them. At first, Naruto always wanted a brother or a sister to be by his side, but with all of them here, he seemed to be forgetting about the idea. As they have all come together nicely, the closest friend she had seen in a very, very long time. The next morning, the trio were walking to the academy. While walking on the road, people wave and smile at them. For two things, well, for Naruto it was two things. He was a son of the Okage, and he was also a Uchiha, and he was also a Senju mixed with that. And for the two Sasa twins, the both of them were Uchiha, the two last Uchihas other from Naruto and his father. And the Uchiha clan was thread thin right now because of what Itachi did, so that made them more respected as the people loved them in the village and didn't want anything bad to happen for them to leave as well. Why couldn't Keiji just fly us to school, Samantha asked. You know how lazy that dragon is, said Naruto. I asked him to fly us this morning, but he's like, no, I'm sleeping. And I don't think he would want to carry all three of us, Naruto said. Yeah, said Samantha, he acts that way, but I know he loves all of us. Yeah, I know that, said Naruto. Over the years, we have really grown a tight relationship. As Sasuke didn't say anything, he just looked at the road ahead. The trio finally made it to the class. The moment Naruto and Sasuke stepped inside, a screech could be heard, as it was all of the fangirls in the class. As the head of this militia was Ino and Sakura, as the rest of the fangirls were in the background. As Samantha sighed, this was always the problem. As she stepped forward, she was pushed out of the way by Ino and Sakura and the rest of the fangirls who rushed towards Naruto and Sasuke. As she just didn't see what is so great, well, Sasuke was her brother and she liked him as a family member. And Naruto, well, she didn't really think about him in any other way than a friend right now. Wait, why did I say right now, she thought to herself. She quickly shook those thoughts of her head as she went to her best friend. She quickly went up the stairs. Hey Hinata, she said, as Hinata smiled and waved back at her. As before this, Hinata was a shy, timid girl that always stayed in her space. But ever since she and Samantha became best friend, Hinata was more vocal and she talked a lot more. And Samantha was glad because she was not one of those brainless girls who always scream and act like total idiots. Some of them are not even worthy to be in the academy right now, because they don't take ninja life seriously. And they should know what the world has ahead for them. They think it's all fun and games, but Samantha knew the true horrors of battle. After what she saw that night, she could never forget it. She shook those thoughts of her head, as she saw Hinata with a frown on her face. Hey, what's wrong? It's nothing, said Hinata. She smiled at Samantha. Come on, how long have we been best friends? I know when you're lying. Well, you see, Dad is just really angry. Again? What now? Well, he said if I fail the exam, I would prove to be a more bigger disappointment, and I would not be fit to be the head of the clan. As Samantha clenched her fist, this was always a problem. Hayashi Hayuga, he always treated his daughter like total garbage, as she hated that. As she saw one time when the man was scolding Hinata, he speak to her and the way he looked at her, it was like he didn't have any love for her at all. Samantha moved closer as she hugged Hinata. It's alright, Hinata. You're not going to fail the exam. Remember, me and you have been training and you have gotten a lot stronger. Trust me, you're gonna pass with flying colors. Hinata hugged back her friend. "You really believe so?" "Of course I do. And you're gonna be a wonderful Kunoichi and the best clan head of the Hyuga. After all, you're going to change the Hyugas, aren't you?" "Yeah, you're right," said Hinata. "Thank you for that," she says. She breathed the hug. "Don't worry, that is what best friends are for." Sasuke then went to take one of the lower seats. As Naruto came up, as he smiled to both Hinata and Samantha, as he took a seat right beside Hinata. As Hinata's cheeks were pink a bit, as she looked at him. "Hello, Naruto," she said. "It's good to see you." "It's good to see you too, Hinata," he said. "Aren't you psyched for the exam?" "Oh, yes. I believe I'm going to pass," she said. "Believe?" Naruto said. "Oh, trust me, you are going to pass. After all, you're one of the best Hyugas anyway, as far as I can see. The rest of them always act rather arrogant, but you, you're one of the best in my eyes." Hearing that, Hinata perked up even more. Thank you," she said. "No problem." Iruka then came to class. "All right, everyone, quiet down." But no one listened to him as he activated his big-headed jutsu. "Quiet down, everyone," he shouted, as all of them turned their attention to him. "Now, today you will be getting your genin test, your final test, to see if you're going to become or you're able to be genins, so you can become a true ninja of Konoha with your head banned," he says. He pointed at his. "This signifies that you're a true ninja of Konoha and that you will serve under the village and protect your home. But this will also come with the responsibilities of going on missions, dangerous missions as you progress. And I wish you all the best and to keep safe out there. Now, this is going to be going by names. So, once I call your name, come to the room and your exam will begin. You will be monitored by me and my assistant, Mizuki." As Mizuki just looked at the class, a smile on his face. Naruto didn't know why, but that guy always ticked him off. It was just something about the guy. The way he spoke to him, it was like he was just hiding something. But he shrugged it off for now, as the names were called, as students went in and came out. Some of them had a smile on their face and their headbands on their head. As Hinata was called, Samantha and Naruto smiled to her. "Good luck," the both of them said. As she nodded, she went inside. About a couple minutes later, she came out. As Samantha and Naruto saw, there was no headband on her forehead. As a sad look came on Samantha's face, but she then noticed Hinata had a smirk on her face. As Hinata zipped down her jacket a bit more, as it was covering up her headband, which she put on her neck. As that made Samantha smile, as Hinata rushed over, "I passed," she said. "I told you you would," said Samantha, as she gave Hinata her biggest smile. "Thanks for having faith in me, the both of you," she said. "No problem," the both of them said. Naruto was then called. As Naruto went to the room. Naruto, you ready?" asked Iruka. "Of course," Naruto said. "Well, the first thing is the transformation jutsu." "Sure thing," Naruto said. As he then went through Hansine. "Transform," he said, as he turned into a perfect replica of his father. "Whoa," said Iruka, "no flaws. Full marks." "Alright, Naruto, the next thing I want you to do is perform the Shadow Clone jutsu." "Sure thing," Naruto said as he went through Hansine. "Wait," said Iruka, but Naruto already finished his Hansine, as he created a clone. As Iruka was shot by Naruto, performing a Shadow Clone with his transformation still on, Naruto and Sasuke were tied for the strongest in the class, but Iruka could tell that Naruto was always holding back something, as he didn't know why though, but Naruto was always holding back, seeing the boy perform this so flawlessly. As the original and the clone looked at each other, as Iruka know that Naruto is going to be something great in the future, he know about Naruto Mokuton. Well, not everyone know, as it wasn't really all around the village, but some special people know that the persons that were close to Naruto and his training and all that. But Minato did tell the council about it, but they decided to keep things quiet for now, as the other nation was going to get really giddy if they ever heard about anything like this. Seeing that Danzo was no longer a part of the council, Minato trusts the council more, as the two elders, Koharu and Homura, have started to open up to him more now, seeing that Danzo was gone. So they all made an agreement to keep it quiet for now, with just a few other people knowing about it. There were also talks about Naruto being under the CRA to try and produce more bloodline users in the village, but that was quickly shot down when Kushina literally told them After Minato told her, as she marched in the council room as an envoy, Nobita could not get in her way. She was known as the hot-haired Nero after all. As she came in there along with Tsunade, who was behind her, as Tsunade was also pissed to hear that they want to use her little precious grandson at a breeding stock, Kushina literally told him that she will kill them all if they try anything like that, and that was quickly shut down. But they did talk about the agreement to at least have him enter a political marriage that would bring an alliance to Konoha, some other great village. As she was willing to think about that, well, if the girl was a nice girl and she was kind to her baby boy, and that was if Naruto liked her back. If Naruto was against it, it was a hard pass. After ending the transformation to the clone, Naruto was next given 3 kunais and 3 shurikens to throw at the target, as Naruto got 3 out of 3, perfect. Aruka gave him his headband, as he was one of them who didn't think that Naruto deserved to take this test. Naruto was already genuine material, and maybe even above that, after he witnessed some of the boys training, and Naruto also possessing his father Rasengan ability, even though his father has pushed it one step farther to infuse it with his chakra nature fire. But he knows that one day Naruto is going to do something even more special. As Naruto got his head banned, as he thanked Aruka and gave a small nod to Mizuki as he left the room, as he came out with a big smile on his face, as everyone was happy for him. As the rest of the name were called, Sasuke and Samantha got their head banned with ease as well, as all of this was pretty simple for them. At the end of the day, Aruka told them that tomorrow will be them meeting their senseis. As Naruto had a good idea that Kakashi was going to be sensei, that man was over his house a lot. Kakashi was almost like a brother to him, as his father had taken in Kakashi after Kakashi lost his teammates Rin and Obito, and his father took him in and get him over his depression, so Kakashi was close to all three of them, Samantha and him, and Sasuke. So he was pretty sure that his father was going to put him under his hand, and he was grateful for that. There was a lot that Kakashi could teach him when he was serious. Well, otherwise from the man being completely lazy and always late for things. After everything was over, Naruto noticed Mizuki talking to Hinata, something that he never did before. As Mizuki walked up to Hinata, "Hinata Hyuga," he said, "I heard that your father has been saying that you're not strong or good enough. I have a way for you to prove him wrong." Hinata narrowed her eyes at Mizuki. What do you mean?" she asked. "Well, come with me," he said, as she just slightly nodded as she walked off with him, as Naruto kept a close eye on them, as he decided to check it out, as Samantha and Sasuke saw him going in the opposite direction. "Hey, where you going?" asked Sasuke. "I'll be home soon. Tell mom that I'm dealing with something," as he ran off before he could explain. As Naruto saw Mizuki then depart from Hinata, as she had a questionable look on her face like she was thinking about something, as Naruto dropped down from the rooftop, as Hinata then stopped, as she rushed over to him rather quickly. "Hinata, what happened?" "Naruto, I need your help," said Hinata. Later that night, Mizuki was in the forest, as he tricked that little girl, telling her that scroll would grant her immense power. The only thing she had to do was take it, and he was giving her an opportunity to show her father that he's wrong, that she's stronger than she seems, as he had no doubt that this would go through perfectly. That girl didn't want to be yelled at and cursed at by her father. She will do it. Mizuki was waiting in the forest for Hinata to show up, the exact position where he told her to come. He then saw her, but to his surprise, she had on no scroll on her back. But his confusion only grew when he saw Naruto, as he had the scroll. "What is going on?" said Mizuki. "I told Naruto what happened and I asked him to help me." Mizuki smirked. He thought that the boy was smarter than this. That is why he didn't go to Naruto, as he knew that the boy would easily see through his plan. But he guessed he was wrong. He was just a dumb, arrogant child. "Hey, Mizuki," Naruto said. "I heard you wanted this." "What?" "No," said Mizuki. "That is for helping Hinata. You know I go to my father's office a lot, and he tells me about things," Naruto said. "And what does that have to do with anything?" "Well, he told me what this scroll is for, and if this should end up in the wrong hands, it will be quite dangerous. So what are you trying to do, steal it? Who are you really, Mizuki? Naruto said. As Mizuki looked at Naruto, as he didn't want anything to go off the plans, he pulled a giant Fuma shuriken from his back. Listen to me. Give me the scroll, or I'll end your life and leave this village and I'll still have the scroll. So you really are a traitor, Naruto said. I thought that I was just speculating. But why though, Naruto said. I'm not going to tell you anything, said Mizuki. Well, you're going to kill me anyway. You're a chunin after all. I'm sure that me and Hinata cannot take you if the both of us team up against you. So, just give me this peace of mind before I die. I guess you're right, said Mizuki. Well, I was going to hand it over to Lord Orochimaru. Because I deserve more. I deserve more power. And he's going to put me as his second in command. Orochimaru? The legendary son, Orochimaru, said Naruto. Yes, at least you know something, you arrogant, ignorant boy. Now hand over the scroll. Is that enough, Naruto asked, as he was looking to his left. Who are you? Mizuki couldn't even finish that sentence, as two kunais were pressed up against his throat. Yes, that's enough, as Mizuki was surrounded by three anvus. What the? He then looked around. You tricked me, he said. Yeah, said Naruto. You're rather dumb, if I must say to myself. You didn't even try to spread out your senses to sense them, just because you're arrogant and overconfident. And by the way, I could have taken you. Before Mizuki could say anything, the anvu chopped him in the back of the neck, knocking him out. As a poof went off in Naruto's hand, as a scroll was replaced with a log, as Naruto dropped the log to the ground. Hinata then sighed. Thank you for helping me, she said. Well, since you told me what he was up to, I know he was up to no good. But it's good on your part for coming to tell me. I'm glad you're safe, said Naruto. Thank you, she said. Now come on, let me take you home. You guys have this, right? Naruto couldn't even finish his sentence. The anvus were already gone. Naruto then put his hand to his lips as he whistled. As he looked up in the sky, what are we waiting for? Asked Hinata. Just give it a second. Suddenly, the breeze started to blow as Keiji descended from the sky as he landed on the ground. Hinata heard about his dragon. She saw a few glimpses of it here and there when she visited, but it was always sleeping and she never saw it awake. And she never really got so close to it. Naruto picked up Hinata's bridal style that made her blush heavily. As he jumped up and placed her on the back of Keiji, as he went to the front, hold on, Naruto said. As she slowly reached out and held onto his shirt. Hey, what the hell do you take me for? You're a ride? Said Keiji. Well, you are a dragon that can fly, and can go places faster, and even fly over water, and can shorten a distance quickly. What do you think you are, Naruto asked. I'm not your damn ride, that is it. You do eat a lot of my food, and you're telling me that you can't simply do this for me? I don't care, said Keiji. Naruto sighed. Always with this attitude. Now come on, let's fly, Naruto said. As Keiji didn't say anything, he just lifted off. As Hinata quickly felt the pull, so she grabbed onto the first thing she could, as it was Naruto, as she wrapped her arms around his waist tight, as the dragon soared through the air. It only took a couple of seconds, about 20 seconds there at least, as Keiji moved rather fast, as he wanted to get back to his nap. As they arrived at the Hyuga compound, as Naruto jumped off with Hinata, as she looked a bit frazzled, you alright? He asked her. Oh, I'm fine, she said, as she was catching her breath. That was intense. Yeah, he's quite fast, Naruto said. Come on, let's go. Aren't you going home? She asked. No, I want to talk to your father about something. My father? She said in surprise. About what? She asked. Oh, just something important. Naruto, my dad is... Don't worry. I spoke to your dad before, when he came to talk to my dad. And he actually liked me, Naruto said. Really? Said Hinata. This is the first you're telling me of this. Yeah, I didn't really have a reason to talk to him before, but now I do. Naruto, is this about me? She asked. Come on, he said, as he walked off, leaving her behind. Hey, I'm not coming back for you, said Keiji. As Naruto turned and looked at him, sure you won't, he said. You think I'm kidding? As Keiji then took off without saying anything. I think he's not coming back, said Hinata. Don't worry, he will, Nerta said. Why are you so sure, she said. Just a little secret, Nerta said to her. And with that, they headed towards the Hayuga compound. As they were stopped at the gate by the guards let in Hinata rather quickly, but they looked at Nerta curiously, wondering what the Hokage-san is doing here. State your business, one of them asked. Oh, I wish to talk to the head of the Hayuga clan. About what, he asked. Oh, it's something important. Come on, you can't leave me out here, Nerta said. He knew I'm going to be here. And you know how grumpy he is. What do you think he's going to say to you all when he finds out that you left someone as important as me out here? I am the Hokage's son after all, Nerta said. As Hinata merely chuckled to herself. Sometimes Nerta really surprised her. When he wanted something, he stopped at nothing to get it. As Naruto was allowed inside, as Naruto saw Hayashi standing right at the entrance of the main house, as the man had a stern look on his face as usual. He didn't address Naruto at first, he looked at Hinata. Where have you been? He said to her. Oh, that's my fault, said Naruto. Why is that? Asked Hayashi. Well, you see, our academy teacher turns out to be a traitor. And he tried to trick Hinata in stealing the scroll so that he could take it for himself. Hayashi glared at Hinata. Don't tell me that you have brought this family's shame by being stupid, he said. Oh, no, not at all, Nerta said, as he saw Hinata was shrinking under her father's gaze. Actually, she didn't take it. We end up getting the Anbus to take him away. He then sighed as he looked towards Naruto. What can I do for you? Can we talk in private, Nerta said, as Hayashi looked at Hinata and gave her a stern glare. As she simply looked at Naruto and gave him a small wave and then she walked off. So what can I help you with? Naruto-san, he said. As Hayashi knew the political power that Naruto has, and it was great. When he saw Naruto coming with his daughter, that made him happy, because if the Hayuga was to marry the son of the fourth Hokage, not to mention the heir of the Senju clan, it would be great political power for the Hayugas, and not to mention if they have kids together, that would lock in the Hayugas for sure. And not to mention the Mokitan. Sometime in the future, things will change and this boy will become something that is precious to the entire world. So that is why he didn't hate this boy. He actually liked him and he didn't act like most kids. He had something around him, something stern, like he wanted to keep on pushing. He has a determined goal. It's about Hinata, Naruto said. What about her, Hayashi asked. Well, I heard that you've been mistreating her. As Naruto saw the scowl came on Hayashi's face, sorry, I misphrased it wrong. Well, I heard that you're planning on taking her from the clan head. Who told you of this? Asked Hayashi. Well, Hinata did. She told you about clan matters? Don't be angry at her, said Naruto. It's just that we're close friends, you know. As Hayashi was happy to hear that, even though he didn't show it on the outside. But there's something I want to tell you. You know that Hinata is soft, right? Yes, I know of that, and that is what makes her weak. No, you're wrong, said Naruto, as his tone changed. She's not weak. That is what made her strong, her emotions. She just doesn't want to hurt people. But if it isn't up to that, Hinata is a capable and strong person who will not disappoint. You really think that her younger sister can defeat her in a spar? Trust me, she can't. Hinata is strong. She's just scared of hurting her younger sister. So that is why I came here and begging you. Just give her a chance. I've seen the look on her face most of the time and she's really sad. And I just don't want her to be sad, Naruto said. Hayashi looked at Naruto. Have you ever seen my daughter fight? He asked. Yes, Naruto said. With Samantha. You mean the other Uchiha? He asks. Yes. And, not to brag, but Hinata has even got Samantha on the rope a couple of times. And imagine this, Samantha was trained by my father, a bit, Jiraiya, and also my grandmother and my mother. We all got training from them, so you can imagine how strong Samantha is at her age. So just imagine how strong Hinata is. So trust me, she just don't want to hurt her little sister. And you see, what is it, said Hayashi. You're not angry at me, right? No, I'm not, said Hayashi. But the way you look at people, that glare on your face, it makes people kind of scared, Naruto said. What, said Hayashi. You really don't see it, Nerta asks.
Well, just check a mirror, Nerta said.
That's not any disrespect, Nerta said, I'm just stating the obvious.
But yeah, that's what I came here to say.
Give Hinata my best, he said as he started to walk off,
as Hayashi just stood there.
As he was thinking about everything the boy just told him, for one thing his face. Well, his glare was to intimidate people. As people think that he hates his daughter, he didn't hate his daughter one bit. He actually loved her very much, that is why he wanted to push her to her full potential. But he has been going too harsh on her. She doesn't even want to fight her full capability because he was too harsh. Perhaps he should change things and do things in a different way. The next morning, they were all in the class as Hinata had a smile on her face, as Naruto stepped in, as he was late.
Where have you been? Said Samantha.
I was helping these old people with their groceries, Naruto said.
But the teacher isn't here yet, said Sasuke, so it's fine.
Naruto looked at Hinata and smiled, as her smile got wider seeing him.
Naruto, what did you say to my father last night?
Huh? Your father? Said Samantha.
Yes, he spoke to my father.
Oh, not very much, Naruto said.
Well, it didn't matter what you say, thank you, said Hinata.
Why though, Naruto asked. Did something happen?
Well, he came in my room and for the first time apologized to me for being too harsh on me.
I don't know what you did, but you're a miracle worker, she said.
Thank you for that, as Naruto just gave her a smile.
Before he could respond though, Iruka walked in the class.
Alright everyone, today you will be getting your senseis. I will be naming them out, so let's begin.
Team 1 to 6 remain the same as canon.
As he reached up to Team 7.
Alright, Team 7. Sasuke Uchiha, Naruto Uchiha, and Samantha Uchiha. As everyone was looking at the team in awe. Hear that 3 Uchihas are on one team. That is certainly going to be something special in the future. Even Iruka knew that something, this would bring some special light and image in the future. 3 Uchihas, the 3 last Uchihas on one team. As he couldn't wait to see what the future has in store for them. As he just hoped that everything will be good. Perhaps they will even get a title as the 3 legendary Sannins, something as that, or something even better for their great powers and strength. Your sensei will be Kakashi Hatake. The rest of the team was called, as there was an odd number of genins. As Sakura Haruno was placed on the same team as Hinata. So that was the first 4-man team with Hinata, Sakura, Shino and Kiba. As Kiba just smiled, he had 2 girls on his team. That was going to pay out good for him. Well, that was at least what he thought. As Shino saw the smile in his face.
Why are you smiling? Shino asked.
Well, just look at it. We have 2 girls on our team. You can get one and I can get one.
Well, if you think about it, Sakura is obsessed with those 2 Uchihas and she doesn't know which one to pick. And Hinata does not like you.
What? Said Kiba.
I'm merely stating the obvious, said Shino as he went quiet.
As Iruka told him to quiet down as he called out their senseis.
As some time passes, senseis came and took the other teams. As Ino waved Naruto and Sasuke goodbye. As Sakura did the same. As Hinata waved Naruto and the others goodbye as well. 2 hours passed.
I knew this was going to happen. I knew this was going to happen. I knew this was going to happen, Naruto kept on mumbling.
As Sasuke was tapping his finger on the table.
You know what we should do, said Samantha.
As an evil look came on her face.
Sometime later, Kakashi finally arrived.
I guess I am late, he said.
As he pulled the door.
But no one was in here.
Where are they? He wondered. He then saw a note on the table. As he went over, reading the note, he just chuckled to himself. As he placed it down and walked away. As the note read,
food, one single word.
As Kakashi found himself at Ichiraku Ramen. When he got there, he saw the 3 kids munching down on ramen.
I knew that I would find you here, he said.
The 3 of them turned and looked at him.
You were late, so we decided to get some lunch.
And besides, we already know you, so we don't have to introduce ourselves to you.
So why don't you sit down and have a bowl with us, Naruto said.
I guess you're right, said Kakashi.
As he sat down with them.
There was supposed to be a test.
The test the 3 of you for your teamwork.
But I'm not gonna do that.
Huh? Why? Sasuke said.
Well, remember, I've worked with all 3 of you in the past. train you together and I can already see that your teamwork is something you don't lack on. Most of the times, when Samantha or Sasuke is in trouble, Naruto, you push yourself in a situation to either protect the both of them, and any one of you do the same for each other, so I don't have to waste my time on that. So just know that we're officially Team 7. Well, that's awesome, Naruto said.
Hey old man, we just became Team 7. More ramen to celebrate, he said.
Coming right up, the old man said.
But guys, be ending this episode right here. If you want to see the next part, if you don't know what to do, like, subscribe, comment down below, and turn that bell notification stay posted. Remember, share to all of your friends, your social media platform, and stay in tune for the rest of what is coming your way. And I hope you guys enjoy each and every one of them. And yeah, without further ado, I'm out for now, guys. See you guys soon. Peace.